trends. For now, though, we're going to talk a little bit about Bitcoin because it's been getting smoked this year. But it's even worse for altcoins. Miles Udland with the chart of the day, and it's a first. It's a crypto chart, Miles.
First crypto chart of the day. So, Jen, we often talk about Bitcoin, but those of you who remember the crypto craze, perhaps the Yahoo Finance All Market Summit crypto edition last year, will know all about altcoins. These are the smaller names. I think Ether, Ripple are kind of the names people might know, but what about Monero? What about Bitcoin Cash?
Menudo.
What about Gollum? You know, these are the names. Dogecoin. These were really making headlines back in the late kind of fall, winter of 2017. So we have here a chart comes from Fundstrat, Tom Lee, kind of the leading Wall Street voice, Wall Street turned crypto analyst. So this is the percent of altcoins that are up more than 200% in 90 days. So these are very small, very volatile assets. Now, Tom's point in this chart is that since we have essentially no altcoins up more than 200% in the last 90 days, we're due for a big super cycle of altcoins lifting off. If you go back to the, let's say, late summer, early fall of 2017, we had about 5, 10% of altcoins up that much. Then we saw a big spike when everyone lost their minds over Bitcoin. This is a pattern that played out earlier in 2017. So the thinking would be, if everything's down a lot, it might as well go back up. Of course, I think we'd all be skeptical. I see both of your faces over there. That just because everything's down 1,000,000% and hasn't gone anywhere in months, that it would go higher. And I think that the price action we're seeing in crypto really suggests a one-way bet on the space, which is we thought it was worth this. It's actually worth a whole lot less. That's the end of it.
I mean, this is, you know, and I love Tom. He's a great guy. He's a smart guy.
He'll be here on
this
Wednesday.
This is like, this is like, first of all, it's technical. It's not fundamentals. It speaks to the paucity of fundamental research here because there is none, zero, zip. And it's tantamount to saying, basically, Miles, that because it was rainy today, it's going to be sunny tomorrow.
Yeah.
I mean,
there must be a reversion to sun.
Over to you, Jen.
Yeah. Which in Seattle.
I mean, come on, man.
Let's say we're in Seattle. Not sunny that much.
Okay.
I just look at this. I mean, we were always trying to figure out what the correlation was.
Right.
Yeah.
To equities. And I just don't, and so now I'm trying to correlate this to what's happening, and my correlation is very different than the idea that it's going to go back up. I think that
when it's scarier,
I think this is telling us, and just the same way like weed's down a ton too right now. I think like all this momentum stuff is not helpful to the bulls.
Well, and I think you know, so we often hear a lot stock market history, right?
Yeah.
When this has happened, this happens next. But the sample size of the stock market is like 120 years. There's only like 6 instances where stocks went down after a midterm and then 4 times went higher, therefore stocks go up, right? Think about how thin that is on a statistical rigor basis, and then think about how thin the crypto market is. It's only existed for 9 years. It's really only been a thing people outside of some weirdos on the internet talked about for maybe 5 years. So the idea, in my view, and I think we're all agreeing here, that because something happened in the past, there would be a setup for it to happen in the future. I kind of look at this and think, well, altcoins are dead. That's
but
it.
That's even like basing it on, you know, historical technical analysis, which I won't get into. You know, I'm not a huge fan. Okay,
right.
But even if you could do that, I would get a comfort level, but you're telling me you can't. And then you get back to my baseline, which is fundamental analysis.
Yeah.
And you can't even like begin,
right?
Because there's nothing. I mean, as soon as someone starts talking about these currencies, you know, evaluating them on a fundamental analysis, the conversation just stops because there really is nothing. And it's sad. I wish there was. I don't have anything against it.
Yeah.
But you really can't go there, right?
Right.
We are going to have Tom in on Wednesday. We'll talk to him about it then.